Today's code review is going to be a fairly short one. The project is from a developer which is self-taught and currently studying to be a Laravel developer. The application currently only have two main features, which is basically a project screen where you've got a list of projects, a create a new project screen. On the project screen, you've got either you can add a task to a project or you can click on the project itself, which will then give you a list of tasks for that project with basic information like a task name, a description, a status, and current user it's assigned to. Hey guys, I'm Dan and this is PixelFix. And hopefully I can point out something in this code review that will help you in your future projects. The current project is really small, but there's about three things that I would show you in order to improve this code and make it better. Also remember, if you've got some code you want me to review or if you want some advice on certain things, there are several ways you can get hold of me. I will leave links in the description to all the places where you can get hold of me. You can also find all those links on the About page on my channel. All right, enough of the admin stuff. Let's look at the code. Okay, so if we look at the routes file, I can see it looks fairly good to start with. It doesn't have a lot of routes in it, but they are grouped nicely together. I can also see proper naming conventions have been followed for the actual route name. The controllers seems pretty good, as well as the resource naming. If you're unsure about naming conventions in Laravel, I'll leave a link in the description to a video I've got that explains the Laravel naming conventions. Okay, so the first thing I want to show you is in the index method for this task controller. If we look at it, we can see it is fairly simple. The project is being passed in, the tasks is then extracted via a relationship, and then both variables are being sent to the front end. So there's a bit of redundant code going on here. We basically don't need to extract the task beforehand, so we can get rid of that. We can get rid of this task over here then. And then instead of sending the data or the project information to the front end like this, we can remove this array and just basically use the compact helper method and say we want to send the project. Now within the blade file, we just need to change the way we access those tasks. Instead of a standalone variable, we can now access it via the project relationship tasks. Now this if for each statement is something I will cover in a sec. So if we look at the if statement, it says if the count of the tasks is bigger than zero, then it runs and lists out all the tasks. Else, meaning that if there's nothing in the array, it just displays a no projects found message. Okay, so now we can basically change this and combine the if and the for each statement in something that's called a for else statement. Now in the first section, which is our loop, we would take our project and call the tasks relationship as a task, and then we would take our table row, which displays each row of the tasks. We would remove that and place it inside the loop like so, and then in the empty section we would then place our section or our row that displays when no tasks are found. And now we can basically remove the if and the for each statement. Okay, now back in our task controller, if we look at our task show method, this is the second thing I want to show you in order to improve this code. Now, if we look at this route, we can see the project is being passed in via route model binding, but the task ID is not. The task is just plainly passed in as an ID. Then the developer manually checks whether the task belongs to the project. If it doesn't, it throws a 404, and if it does, it returns that task to the front end. Now, this is a lot of manual checking, which we don't need to do, since in our route, we can utilize something that's called scoped bindings. Now, scoped bindings is a feature in Laravel that basically do this checking for us. It basically checks whether the second model is a child of the first model, and then automatically throws a 404, if it's not. Now, in order to do this, we can just say we want the route and we want to call the scope bindings on it and we want to place it inside a group, and we open up a callback method, and then we place all our routes that would rely on scope bindings inside our group, like so. Okay, so what we can do now is we can change this to task, because we're going to rely on route model and scope bindings in order to get our task injected into our controller method. Now, in our task controller, we need to type int our task that we're going to receive. And now we can basically remove these lines, as route model binding and scope bindings will inject and find the model for us. And now again, we can change this line. Instead of passing it as an array, we can say compact, and we're going to pass in the task. And now you can see this whole method has been reduced to one line of code. Okay, so the last thing I want to show you is back in the routes file, where we have our project task routes. Now, what we can do is, because these routes all follow the resource naming conventions, we can place them in a resource route. So we can create a route called resource, and then we can say it'll be the project tasks resource, which we will then call our task controller class. And now we can basically remove all these routes, because the index, create, show, store, and update are all resource methods in a resource controller. So if we remove that, and now it should work exactly the same as before. And that's it for this episode, guys. See you later.